Hello everyone and welcome back. It's never a boring day supporting this football club, I think is the best way to start this video off. Within the space of 2 days, we have went from Anthony Gordon being out between 6 to 7 months to him now, within the hour when I'm recording this video, he is set to be in the England squad for the next international break. For the first time, he's been able to progress up from the under-21s to player of the tournament last summer. He is now going to be in Southgate's team. And I don't believe it. Southgate's actually picked players based on merit, based on performances, and not based on the fact it's Jordan Henderson who played good 6 years ago. We're actually picking players based on how well they played this season, which is, I can't believe it, the actual correct thing to do. But of course, if you watched my video 2 days ago and you've been on social media over the past couple of days, how have we went from Gordon being out for 6 to 7 months to all of a sudden him being more or less match fit now? What has happened here? Why have I made a video addressing this information when that information has been completely false? So I want to start things off now by pretty much telling my side of the story, just telling you everything, my point of view that has happened. And I'll obviously apologise as well because I did get it completely wrong. Now, ITK accounts, so these are people that on Twitter, social media, or people who claim they have sources from the club and they spread information across social media. And in this case, it was completely false. It was so far off the mark. So why have I then took that information from an ITK account and actually put it across in the video? Now, ITK accounts, in particular, this individual who actually posted the stuff about Gordon, honestly, they are credible. They do get stuff correct. Now, this guy before, he was able to get information out about Kieran Trippier, the Bayern Munich links, before it was reported anywhere by journalists. The likes of Callum Wilson, the extent of his injury, again, information that has came out before, it has been put across from any journalist. It's information that he wouldn't have been able to guess. It's information you wouldn't have been able to know unless someone's physically taught him. So based on that, the assumption is someone at the club is obviously telling this guy stuff, and therefore he makes him quite a credible source. But in this particular case, Gordon out for 6 to 7 months. I don't know where he's got that from. I don't know why he's put that in social media. And obviously, it is so far off the mark. So straight away for me, in regards to ITK accounts and just anything like that, my videos, I mean, especially the way I present the video, just no. It's an absolute no-go now. I'm not putting over it anymore. It may be a case where I talk about it in a snippet of the video, but it won't be presented, it won't be in the title, it won't be in the thumbnail. It's just a case now that it's not happening. It's not going anywhere near the video. So, yeah, I just wanted to come across now. I'd apologise on behalf of myself as well. I did get it completely wrong. It is what it is. I can't deny it, and I'm only apologise now and move on forward. But obviously, the positive news is that Gordon is not out for 6 or 7 months. It's highly likely that he'd be more or less fine for next week, maybe even City the weekend. By the fact he's actually been called up to the international team, it means that he is somewhat capable of playing during the international break. So he's definitely close as what we can say from it. It's very good information to take. Or player of the season for me, I think he is Newcastle's best performing player this season. And the fact he hasn't sustained such a long, horrible injury is a good thing. We can't complain about it, can we? I mean, what would you guys rather want? Would you rather have that information be correct and Gordon out for half a year? Or would you rather me and these accounts be wrong and Gordon's all of a sudden back? It's obviously the great news. We've got City now on Saturday, and well, it's not just the Gordon news that is quite good. In a Manchester City point of view, we've also got some quite good injury news coming from their camp, because Kevin De Bruyne has actually been pulled out of the Belgian squad because of a little groin issue he has. Now, obviously, I don't think the injury is that serious. I think they took him out straight away because of the fact that they have Arsenal the week after the international break. That was a huge league game for them, especially after they just drew against Liverpool. They now have to win the Arsenal game in order to solidify their position at the top of the table. But based on that information, the fact that De Bruyne has been pulled out of rest, I actually don't think he'll play the Newcastle game, which is the big talking point, because if you remember the game at St James's Park, I think City only won because of De Bruyne. He came on, scored an equaliser, and had an amazing pass for Oscar Bolt to score the winner. If he takes De Bruyne out of that City team at St James's, I thought Newcastle had a result there. That was a point in the season when Newcastle were struggling. They had no options on the bench. Manchester City bring Kevin De Bruyne in, it completely changes the game, flips it on its head, and City walk away with 3 points in the game that Newcastle actually played well in. It's for us now at the Etihad in front of well over 8,000 travelling Newcastle United fans to grind out a result. We beat them, we're going to Wembley, and that's the biggest game of our season now. No lying about that at all. You look at the league performances, we're mid-tier now, we're 10th, we've got a lot of climbing to do. We've still got some big matches, still got to play like some Tottenham, Man U, still got to play West Ham, still got to play Brighton at St James's Park. But for us, chance to go to Wembley, would you say yes to it? Of course you would. So it's up to us now to cause the upset at City. City, I probably think, have one eye on Arsenal the week afterwards, as I just mentioned before. The fact that De Bruyne has been kept out of the Belgian team heavily implies he's going to play the Arsenal game. But I honestly think they won't play him at all against Newcastle. I don't think they will. I think they'll maybe potentially underestimate us a little bit, or maybe just think, well, you know what? Let's keep De Bruyne out of this game. We should beat Newcastle regardless. Let's put these players in and we should be fine. But in reality, De Bruyne was the thing that won City the game last time. So it's up to us to cause it upset. I think we definitely got it in our bank. We've lost 1-0. We've beaten 1-0 in the Carabao Cup. We've narrowly lost at St James's Park. It's not like they've been battering us this season. They might have done in certain areas of the pitch at times. But Newcastle actually do stand toe-to-toe with these big teams now. But as you've seen, Arsenal away, Tottenham away, I wouldn't even say the big anymore, but Chelsea away would have been horrible. Horrible in some of these big fixtures. And I think especially when it's the big six in away matches, Newcastle statistically don't win at these games. We'll beat Aston Villa this season, who are going to finish in the top six. We'll beat Man U, who are rubbish in the cup. And we'll beat Tottenham last season away when they finished seventh. So when it's an actual big squad away, we just don't tend to get the results in. So City has to be different if Newcastle have got any chance of getting into the semi-finals of the FA Cup. We've had some horrible luck with the draws this season, but we've got to deal with it now. We've got to take on City, and we've got to try and beat them. And hopefully we will beat them. It's a bit intriguing, actually, to see whether Newcastle would play Gordon on the weekend if he's fit. Because, again, he's been called up to the England squad. What they're going to do there? Is he almost back? Is it a case where he's dodged a bullet? He can come back in the team straight away. It's an interesting one to find out, so time will tell, I'm sure. Next video I'll make probably will be at the City game, actually, unless something big comes out tomorrow. So, fingers crossed for it. I'm sure things will go well. But, yeah, some positive news today I thought I'll come out in the video with. And obviously, I want to address the Anthony Gordon stuff as well. As I mentioned before, ITK account's just completely out of it now. Not going anywhere near my videos. So, I want to make that as clear as possible. But, appreciate you guys watching. I wish you all the best. Enjoy City if you're going down. Hopefully I get to see you all there. Take care, and I'll see you all in the next one.